Hello then, and welcome to the very sort of live. Yes, this is live.
I'm Aspen. We're also there, Max.
And this one is for the hashtag.
Hola, uno.
Hi. Yes, that's correct. Hi.
Falta solo falta.
Ah, okay, it's okay.
Kevin here. We'll have to ask him how that one goes over the weekend. Of course, Kota, a place that is probably one of the toughest circuits on the calendar. Unfortunately, we can't see the rest of the track right now, but as you'll know, if you've watched the GP before, it really is a massive test for all the riders. There's the main man that everyone's really been talking about then, just talking to Dorna Sports CEO Carmelo Spalletta, and there's Andrea Dovizioso as well. But Marc Márquez is finally back. I say finally, only missed one race. But after another episode of Diplopia, the 8-time world champion does return. Thankfully, the episode wasn't as bad as the one previous, but saw him out for 3 to 4 months. So it's looking though as though Mark should be returning to full fitness this weekend, or somewhat close to it. Of course, we had a little live earlier on that would have been with my colleague and good friend Jack Appleyard. You may well have seen that one when Mark was going for his final medical check. And as we understand, it was all good to go, so hopefully we'll see him lining up for FP1 and heading out on track tomorrow. I think you are mid just where it's a headbutt, the boom mic hanging overhead of him there. So some football skills being on show. Andrea Dovizioso will be an interesting one, of course. Did a good job here last year as he, well, had only just jumped onto the now RNF Yamaha, of course, last year it was Patronus Yamaha. Jack Miller, if you remember, was actually one of the pre-race favourites last year, but I think he had some struggles with tyres in the race. So Jack will be looking for a little bit of redemption this year. And of course, as in 2021, Jack's had a difficult start for the year, So we know that he's going to be able to come out swinging at some point. So really then, as we say about this, is of course to celebrate the 500 Grand Prix. Paul Espargaro has been there for quite a few of them, but not quite as 500 as go all the way back to 1992, of course. There's Jake Dixon just talking to Remy Gardner. Of course, Dixon got his first top five in Moto2, but I think it was for over a year last time out. So Dixon back on form, certainly looking like his old self that we know him to be. And Luca Marini, he had a little bit of a difficult race, but much more promising weekend last time out in Argentina. So we know that the rookie, of course, adapting still to that GP22. We've heard of the problems that Ducati have had in the last few races, just adjusting that GP22 to the riders and how they want it. And really, this is another one that you can see on screen here that's had a few problems adjusting to a new bike. Alex Marquez, of course, just said he's had no confidence in the front end, but we know that Alex is a very good rider, and of course, Cota is a place where, well, Marquez is a name that's situated very well with this place. So hopefully, Alex can find a little bit of Mark Magic as well this weekend and come out firing. So if we talk about a little bit more of the history of the World Championship, of course, because this photo opportunity we do have for us is really just to celebrate the 500 Grand Prix that Dorna have had in this racing together era. Really, of course, you know, when we think of America, we've had great races in America. Of course, this man burst onto the scene in 2013, becoming the youngest ever Premier Cast winner. I think it was 70 years and 60 days or something. Something ridiculous. But I'm sure that 2013, both to me and everyone else watching, just seemed a long time ago now, when this man was much more of a baby-faced assassin and not the seasoned warrior that he is now. Particularly after the last few years of injury struggles and coming back to defy the odds. And really, those two on screen, that's kind of what everyone wants to see in 2022. Pecco Bagnaia and Marc Marquez going head to head. We had a fantastic glimpse of it in 2021 at Aragon. Of course, I'm sure that many of you will know the race as soon as I mention it. But if you don't know the race and you're wondering what happened at 2021 Aragon GP, make sure you go and watch it back on MotoGP.com with a video pass, because it really was one of those battles that we're going to remember for a long time. I think it was seven times Marc Marquez tried, and seven times he was denied, unfortunately, by Pecco Bagnaia. And these two, actually, Fabio and Pecco, shared the podium last time out here last year, when we were here in, I believe, October at the end of the year. And I think, to be honest, one of the topics that's on everyone's minds really at the moment as well is what can this man do on the Yamaha for the rest of the year, and particularly here. He was second here last year to Mark, I think, about 4.5 seconds off where Marquez was in the end. So it was a pretty good showing here for Fabio last year, but of course everything's going to change this year. Cota's been partially resurfaced, or largely resurfaced, shall I say, from turns 2 all the way to 10, I believe, and then from turns 12 to 16. They've resurfaced it to help with the bumps. Of course, the aim is to get rid of the bumps entirely, or at least to reduce the effect of them as much as possible. And that's one of the things that the riders have spoken about. If you watch the pre-weekend press conference earlier today, Aleix Espargaró spoke of it, so did Mark as well, just about now, hopefully, they should be able to set the bike up solely for the track and not set it up for the bumps. So you never know, this weekend could be some very, very fast lap times in MotoGP as we get rid of some of the bumps and the frustrations around the Cota circuit. So I think most of the riders by now have made their way onto the grid, so hopefully we should have some photos very, very soon indeed. Of course, this is a big weekend, sorry, for Aleix Espargaró. The first time he's leading the MotoGP World Championship. And I think everyone will join me in saying that it was absolutely fantastic to see Aleix and Aprilia get their first victory last time out in Argentina. And they really did deserve it. They were fantastic all weekend. And they've been fantastic ever since this new RSGP came out, really. In 2020, they kind of changed the game a bit. They switched from one philosophy to another. And then for 2021, we saw them improve on that bike massively. And now really they're playing the same game as everyone else. They're just fine tuning that machine, and we're really seeing fruits of the labor from it, particularly now Maverick has stepped into the fold as well. And we've got two top class riders on those Aprilia RSGPs. And really, to be honest, I don't think I've seen Aleix as relaxed as he seemed in that press conference earlier today as well. Certainly the pressure, shall we say, of being on a MotoGP, on the top of a MotoGP standing, world standing, is really not getting to him at all, because he's a seasoned veteran anyway, so he's certainly not really going to be feeling it too much. And on the topic, of course, of Aprilia and Maverick Vinales, it was fantastic to see Maverick really start to fire up on that Aprilia and click with it. Of course, we know how the Yamaha relationship ended sadly last year in Austria, but ever since then, it's been this learning process with Maverick to really understand the way that this V4 works, massively different from the inline 4 Yamaha. And it seems that slowly he's starting to figure it out. He looked fantastic on the bike in Argentina. And hopefully they come to a circuit where the Aprilia should work. We heard earlier in the season how they were working on the agility and flickability of that bike. And Kota, if you think of kind of turns 2 all the way through to turn 9, well, that is exactly where you need agility, but also a good handful of stability as well. So certainly this weekend could be one where we see that Aprilia RSGP just really step into its own element again. I'm sure that Aleix will be hoping that as well. So as we see then, the riders starting to get into formation. A shout out to all our coordinators on the ground. It's not an easy job sourcing all the riders to get them into the right places at the right times, but they're doing a fantastic job of it here. And really for America as well, of course, Mark is going to be the heavy favourite, won here 7 times in 8, but let us know what you think as well. You can tweet us at MotoGP on Twitter, or even get involved in some of our Facebook groups. MotoGP Fanatics is one where people like to talk about the weekends coming up, or even join the MotoGP Reddit. There's a good one. MotoGP subreddit, our MotoGP, that's a good place to go and have a chat about MotoGP. But yeah, let us know what you think. Let us know who you think could be on the podium this weekend. Of course, going down the road as well, there's certainly going to be a lot of chatter about who will be the ones to go all the way in this championship. And really, with such unpredictability, this year in MotoGP, 9 different podium finishes out of a possible 9 from the first 3 races, it's pretty incredible. So it does seem that the photos are going down. So I hope all the boys have got a nice smile on their face. And there we go, big thumbs up for the camera. Of course, all these photos and more and videos that are coming up over the weekend will be available on MotoGP.com for your viewing pleasure, as well as on our social channels. Make sure you follow us everywhere. Stay tuned for the latest, and I'm sure that over this weekend there are going to be quite a few storylines that will be unfolding. One of the ones that we'll be keeping an eye on, of course, is this is a big test for KTM this weekend. KTM this weekend look as though, sorry, this year look as though they've really come out with a bike that should hopefully be able to fight all season long and not show those sporadic bursts of insane speed and then have some races where they struggle. And of course, Kota is a track where they've not fared too well in the past, but with the way that that bike has evolved and updated, it's certainly going to be a test of the new metal that we see with KTM at the moment. Another team that's worth mentioning, of course, that we haven't mentioned too much so far is Suzuki. You can see Yoamir there just on the left of the screen. Can't actually quite see Alex Rins, but I'm sure he's there somewhere. They've had a massively solid start, understatedly solid, to be honest. They've had a great start, of course. Alex and Johan have followed each other over the line each time, pretty much. And that does seem as though Suzuki is going to be their launch pad to have a really, really strong challenge in 2022. Of course, Mir, some big comments coming from here after the Argentina Grand Prix, said that he finally had those 2020 feelings back. And that is quite a warning shot for him. Not too sure what happened with Fabio then. But yes, quite a big warning shot from Suzuki if Mir can find those 2020 feelings once more. So that does appear to be it then for a very quick photo shoot for GP500. Of course, signalling the start of Dorna, Erta, MSMA and the FIM period in MotoGP from 1992, all the way back from Suzuka 1992 when I believe it was Mick Doohan that won. So many legends that have gone in this period. If we think back, you know, I myself wasn't around back then for the 1992 season, but certainly looking back to it, you can appreciate just some of the legends that have been created just from some very, very quick guys going and riding their motorcycles. So I believe that one is going to round us up then. Of course, GP500 this weekend. Make sure you don't miss it. I'm sure that you'll enjoy the America's GP. Lots of stories coming up for us this weekend. Marc Marquez returns. Fabio and Yamaha really need to start firing on all cylinders to prove that their championship challenge is going to last the whole way. Suzuki coming into the fold. We've got Aleix Espargaró and Aprilia at the top of the standings. And of course, not too far behind him, we've got some people that we maybe didn't expect to see so far up early on. Enea Bastianini being one, Brad Binder being another, and I think there's 10 points covering the top six after three rounds. It's going to be electric. Make sure you tune in to the America's GP, whether you're watching online on MotoGP.com or if you'll broadcast it in your area. And for now, that is going to be it from the GP 500 photo shoot. Thank you very much for watching.
Yeah, the social media guys. Oh, well, he'll probably put you in touch with us as well, but the new head of...